Hello everyone, welcome to IoT Frontier. My name is Hariharnath. Today we'll be working on an end-to-end project which monitors the temperature and humidity values from a sensor using MingStack. Ming refers to four tools: Mosquito MQTT, InfluxDB, Node-RED and Grafana. The data flow of this project is as per the flow diagram shown. We use DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor interfaced with Raspberry Pi. We run Python code on Raspberry Pi to publish sensor data using MQTT to MQTT broker, which is Mosquito MQTT broker here. Then we use Node-RED to subscribe to the MQTT data and write the data to the InfluxDB, which is time series NoSQL database. Finally, we use Grafana, which is an analytical and visualization application to monitor the sensor data. To complete this project, there are so many steps to perform. So stay tuned until the end of this video to get all the steps right. Let's get started with the installation of all necessary softwares on Raspberry Pi. So that's why I have opened Raspberry Pi. So this is the Raspberry Pi terminal, and I have used my laptop to connect to the Raspberry Pi using PuTTY. Next thing is to install softwares one by one. The first software I'll use is Mosquito MQTT. So for that, I need to follow some steps. So I'll paste sudo apt update and sudo apt upgrade so that first it will update our repository. And once this is done, we will install using this command. Now, to enable Mosquito service on boot of the Raspberry Pi, we need to provide systemctl enable mosquito.service. Next, we need to check Mosquito with -v, then we can see it is already running, that's why we can see address already in use. So now we can go to the mosquito.conf and try to include some settings to allow the listener port to be 1883 and allow anonymous as true. So I'll use Control X and Y and enter. Now it has saved. So we need to restart the Mosquito. So it has already restarted. Next thing, we need to install Node-RED. So for the Node-RED, I have a script. So I need to run this script. So I'll click on Y, enter. So it is asking we need to install the Pi specific nodes. Then I'll say yes. So it will do all the remaining steps like stopping the existing Node-RED and removing the old one and remaining steps that we are seeing here. I'll fast forward this. Now it is asking for the settings file. I'll simply put enter. I'll give default. And username, I'll give Pi, and password, full access, no, I'll use blank, okay, so now we can see Node-RED has been installed. So we can use node-red as well. But I'll use node-red-pi with maximum old space size is equal to 256. Due to limited memory of Raspberry Pi, we can use this so that it will not take much memory. Now we can see under the localhost 1880, we have Node-RED running. So I stopped it. Now, if I want to run this as a service, I can simply use Node-RED -start. so that it will run as a service. Even though if I use Control C, it will run in the background. Next is installation of InfluxDB. So first we need to add the Influx repository key to our Raspberry Pi. So for that I'll paste here. Once this is done, we'll add its repository to our sources list. Once this is done, we can use sudo apt update so that it will find the latest version of Influx data from its repository, and after that we can install the InfluxDB2. So now we can see InfluxDB is installed. After that, we need to do couple of steps. First one is unmasking InfluxDB, and second is enabling InfluxDB as a system CTL so that we can start them as a service. Now we have started the InfluxDB as a service. We need to configure the InfluxDB, so I'll do that at the end after completion of Grafana as well. So what I can do is again add the Grafana APT key to our Raspberry Pi keychain. So once this is done, I need to add the Grafana repository to our package source. Next, I need to update our APT. Now we can install Grafana. So once this is done, we can also enable Grafana service by boot by using this command. So we're not finding grafana.server. So first we need to install the Grafana. So that is the step missing. So I'll first install the Grafana, then we'll find that. Now we can see Grafana is installed. Now we can enable that Grafana server to run at the boot, so we won't get any error, and we also can start the Grafana server. So we can use the systemctl start Grafana server. So it has started. So it will be using 3000 port. So now we have completed the installation steps of all the four tools. So we can configure them right now. Now to configure, we need to use the IP address. So if config and we'll get the IP address of WLAN 0, we can use that in our laptop. So this and 1880, if I open, we'll be able to see the node red. We need to provide the username and password. Now Node-RED is ready. Next thing we need to make ready is InfluxDB. So same IP address, and we need to use 8086. So we need to click on get started, give the username. So I given a bucket name as sensor data and continue. Now we need to copy this so we can go with the quick start. So we can also go to the sources, and we have buckets. So first is sensor data. So next thing we can do is Grafana. So we can go to Grafana. So we can use the same IP address, that is this, and port is 3000. So the username and password is admin, and then we need to change the password. So now we have done the configuration, basic configuration of Node-RED. InfluxDB and Grafana. Next thing we need to do is, we need to first make our source, that is DHT sensor, to properly work. So first, we need to make sure we have Raspberry Pi and as well as DHT11 sensor. So in DHT11, we have two types, that is 3-pin and 4-pin. So using this schematic, you can connect to the GPIO pins. And once you have connected, we can log in into Raspberry Pi and again check into the code. Let me first log in. So I have this Raspberry Pi. So there are few steps that I need to perform. Is first we need to set up Python program. So because we are going to run a Python publisher for MQTT, we need to run apt install python 3, we need pip as well as virtual environment. So there are already available, so there is, it has given like this, and we need to create a DHT11 directory. So I have already created, and now we can go to DHT11. So now we are into DHT11. Next thing is we need to create a virtual environment. So virtual environment is created. We need to activate the virtual environment using this command. Now you can see here we are inside the virtual environment. Next thing is we need to install a couple of pip packages that we are going to use. The first one is for the DHT. Second one is Paho MQTT. So the requirement is already satisfied because I have already installed them previously. Next thing is about the program. So we need to run the program. So I have already created one program, that is mqtt.py. So this is the program here. I'll just open in Visual Studio Code for easy reference. So this is the program that I have written. Let me explain. So here we can see import statements. The important things that we can see is the library that we have recently installed, that is Adafruit DHT and Paho MQTT. Next thing, these are some of the constants. So first we are using localhost and then interval as 2 seconds. Then sensor data we have initialized with temperature and humidity. So we are creating a client, that is MQTT client. And then DHT device is equal to DHT11 initialization, and the board based on the schematic as I shown, we are using board.d4, that is the pin number, so that we are using here. And then we are connecting the client with this port as well as keep alive interval. So next we have in the while loop, we have this humidity. We are getting humidity and rounding it off by 2. Same way for temperature, and we are printing the value as well as making this sensor data object, and inside this we are creating this, and finally publishing client.publish into the topic called DHT11/sensor data. We use json.dumps to send as a JSON data, and every 2 seconds it will keep on running this. So this is the program that we have copied and pasted in the Raspberry Pi. Now I can simply run this program using Python 3. So now we can see the Python 3 program is running and getting some data and pushing that values to the MQTT topic that we have seen. So once we have set up this Python programming, we need to go to the Node-RED. So inside this Node-RED, we need to set up our remaining steps, that is subscribing to the MQTT. So I'll take the MQTT in. So I'll add a new broker, that is localhost, because it is running inside the Raspberry Pi, we can use localhost simply, and we don't have any security, so we'll just add it. And the topic that we want to listen, as we have seen, is DHT11/ I'll copy it from here. Sensor data. We can use quality of service 1 and then click on done. Next thing, we can just use the debug node to understand what is the value that we are getting. So if you go to the debug, we can understand here the object, JSON object, is being read here. So now simply what we can do is we can install influx if it is not there, because if I am searching I don't find influx nodes. So what I can go, I can click on here, manage palette, and go to install and search for influx. So now we have the second one, that is contrib influx db. We can click on install. So it has installed it. Now we can search for influx. So we can see influx out, which is a simple influx db output node to write values and tags to influx db measurement. So I can use that. So I'll configure this. I'll first add the server. So this is, again, I can use local host, and the version is 2.0. It is asking for the token. So if you don't have token right now, what you can do is you can go back, click on the second one, that is API tokens, and you can generate a new token, all access API token, and you can say this is for Node-RED, and click on save. So I'll copy this and paste it here. I have added, and what is the bucket name? So bucket name, you can go back again, go to buckets, we have sensor data. So I'll use the same one. And we don't have any measurement right now, we have not created. So we can create like DHT11, that is a measurement. And click on done. Now we can deploy. So we are getting error from this one, unauthorized access. So we can check that. Maybe the token hasn't properly pasted. So I'll go again, create, delete this token, generate another token. Yeah, now it has pasted. I'll update it, click on done and deploy. So it is asking for organization. I have not given the correct one. So that's why the error is there. Click on deploy. Now we should not see any error. So we are seeing only debug values here. So we can go back to the buckets, sensor data, and here if you click on this DHT11, we'll be having humidity and temperature. We can click on submit. So I'll just use temperature and click on submit. If you click on just a table, we can see the recent values. So every 2 seconds we are getting these values. Same way for humidity, if I select, I'm getting 2 tables. Now we are good with InfluxDB as well. Next thing is go to Grafana. So click on this data sources. We have data source as InfluxDB, and we can use Flux program language, localhost 8086. Now we have this token, it is asking for again. So I can create one more token. This is just for influx db, won't save. I'll copy this, paste it default bucket. So default bucket, I can just again go here. The bucket we have is sensor data and save and test. So we can see three buckets found and save and test is working. So now configuration of source of InfluxDB is done. We can create a dashboard. So click on create a dashboard, add visualization, and this is the InfluxDB we are using data source. Now here we can use a sample query. So how we can find the sample query is you can go back to the InfluxDB, click on sensor data, DHT11, click on humidity and then script editor. So you will get a value here. So this is the script. You can again use it here. So I'll keep this as last 15 minutes. So we are not seeing much data change here in the humidity. So the panel title I'll keep as humidity and save dashboard. So I'll use DHT11 dashboard. So now in the DHT11 dashboard we can see the humidity value. If you want to add one more, so you can click on here, add visualization. So just the way we have used, we can go back to the query builder. Instead of humidity, we can use temperature and click on script editor. So we can take this value. So I'll just remove this yield name and refresh here. So I'll get all the values. This is for temperature and save dashboard. So now here also I'll go back and remove the yield as a mean and save dashboard. So this is how you have created temperature and humidity values. Next thing, you also can create another visualization. So you can click on, if you want to create a gauge, right? So you can click on top and in the visualization you can click on gauge. So here I'll again use the temperature, remove the mean. Temperature, and I can again check here. So I can provide minimum and max values. So here somewhere we can find min and max. So min is 0 and max is 100, so that we can see it has changed its format. Now we can click on save and go back to the dashboard. So what we can do is we can again use last 15 minutes value. So now we can see the value of humidity is changed somewhat. That's why we can see the value, and the temperature is also changing like this, and we can see the value mentioned here. That's all for today's video. I hope this video is informative and has guided you step by step on how to monitor data using MQTT, InfluxDB, Grafana along with Node-RED. If you have liked this project, please type helpful in the comment section below. Your support means a lot to us and helps us keep creating more content like this. So please subscribe to the channel and like this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in another interesting video.